He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Okay, let's look at a problem regarding free energy and non-standard conditions. Consider the following reaction and the non-standard conditions below. So we have 2NH3 yielding 3H2 plus N2, and we have the standard free energy change as being equal to 33.0 kilojoules per mole. Now, here are the non-standard conditions we were referring to. We have a temperature of 25 degrees Celsius, and then we have some pressures for these three gases. For ammonia, that's 12.9 atmospheres. For hydrogen, that's 0.250 atmospheres. And for nitrogen, that's 0.870 atmospheres. Now, we call these non-standard conditions because we are not at equilibrium. We are also not at standard temperature. So the free energy change is not going to be the standard free energy change. It's going to have a different value because the standard free energy change is calculated at standard conditions. If we are not under standard conditions, we have a different delta G value. So we are going to want to calculate that here. What is the free energy change for this process? So that's all the data we need. Go ahead and give this a try. So let's put our reaction up top and let's put all of our information right there. So we are going to need to use this equation. We know that delta G, meaning the free energy change of some process under some conditions that are not standard conditions, is going to be equal to the standard free energy change plus RT ln Q, where Q is the reaction quotient. So let's plug in what we know. We know that the standard free energy change is 33.0 kilojoules per mole. That was given to us. Then for R, that's the gas constant, we are going to use the version of the gas constant that is 8.314 joules per mole K. And in particular, we are going to want to convert this into kilojoules per mole K because we need it to agree with the free energy change value. So that's in kilojoules per mole. So let's take this and divide by 1,000. That gives us 0.008314 kilojoules per mole K. Then temperature, as we said, is 25 degrees Celsius, which, as always, we convert into Kelvin. So that's 298 K. Now for Q, that's the reaction quotient. So that is going to be equal to the concentrations of the products raised to the powers of their stoichiometric coefficients divided by the concentration of the reactants raised to the powers of their stoichiometric coefficients. So here, rather than concentrations, we can just use pressures. And so let's take the pressure of H2, which is 0.250, and let's raise it to the third power because we have 3H2. And let's multiply by the value for N2, which is 0.870. And then we will divide by the value for NH3, which is 12.9, and we will square that because we have 2NH3 in the equation. And so if we do the arithmetic, Q is going to be equal to 8.17 times 10 to the negative 5. Now to get delta G, let's first take our standard free energy change value, that's 33.0, and we'll subtract from that RT ln Q, so we can put that in the calculator all at once. That will come out to 23.3. And that gives us a delta G value of 9.7 kilojoules per mole.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.